Well, hey, everybody, and welcome to The Grid. It's a little dicey here doing these live things on location. My name is Scott Kelby. I'm joined by one of the coolest guys in the world, KelbyOne instructor. Sorry, we just heard like a giant bong go off here. And by a bong, I mean people are smoking marijuana. No, it was like a bong in the room. But this is Gabriel Biderman.
Hello, everyone. How you doing?
It's okay if we call you Gabe, right?
Yes.
Good, because I've called Gabe that his whole life. As long as I've known, it's been a Gabe fest. Anyway, we are very, very glad to have you guys joining us. Now, our original plan was to have set up in the store.
That's correct.
Apparently, a lot of people are at the store today. It's a very busy place, wouldn't you say?
There was a lot of people and a lot of events going on.
A lot of events. Yep. So we were up here for a completely different event, but at B&H, but just not Gabe's cool world of events. We were on the other side of the street. Anyway, but we are so glad to have you here. And Gabe, you happen to be an expert on night photography.
I am an expert on night photography.
Haven't you written a book on night photography?
I have written a book on it.
Haven't you done a KelbyOne class on night photography?
I have recently done a KelbyOne class, yes.
You are, as Larry Becker actually quoted you on Twitter, the Dark Knight. That is who you really are. Anyway, we're glad to have you guys here. Here, I'm going to see if my tweet will go. Hold on. I did a tweet, and then it didn't go.
It's out there now.
It's just out there. So this would be a great time for you to go tell your friends. Scott and Gabe are on the ugly background. Come watch.
We are inside, really deep inside the grid right now.
We're deep inside. We're in places at B&H that even the B&H employees don't know about. This is the secret room
where all
the lenses are kept.
Yep. Underneath us. You can't see them.
We are on a pile.
Like, what was Yertle the Turtle? Was on a pile of turtles.
Yes.
We are precariously on a pile of lenses right now.
We are. And I'm over here checking my things. So let's say, all right, I want to give a few shout outs to start off because people are shouting out. We want to say hi to Jeff from Tarpon Springs. We've got, who is VJM from Vancouver, Canada?
Ah.
See what you did there.
Yeah, that's a
Vancouver.
Smart one.
Yeah, it is. Johan's here from Holland. Matthias from Sweden. Let's see. So UF Photography asks, is this going to be live from the event space or just someplace else in the store? We're close to the store. We're in the same city as the store. we couldn't get into the store. Now, a lot of people are there, which is one of the reasons why they got a lot of stuff going on over there today. So we're actually in a different building. Probably owned by the CIA. It's the NSA Listening Center.
Yeah.
Deep within B&H. We got Norway's in the house. Sandre's here from Norway. Matt Ternitsky is here all the way from the internet.
Where's that?
Hey, Joe. Joe's become a regular. Joe Valencia is from the Jersey Shore. Greetings from the Jersey Shore. Now, Joe says when I go to Jersey next time, he's going to take me for the best burger in Jersey.
Oh, so. Is it that big one? There's like that huge one.
Oh, I don't know.
Yeah.
He didn't really give me any details. He just
all
said,
right,
it would
Joe,
be really
let
good.
Us know.
Jock's Photos here from Kauai.
Aloha.
Doggone it.
Die, beat you to it.
Jock. Jock is in Hawaii. Me and Gabe are in some windowless room where they do interrogations and stuff, you know. And Die Photos says, hi, Scott and Gabe. And Ian. Ian's from London. Hello. He says, hello from London, gents. Good to have you guys here. We're very glad to have you. We're going to be talking about night photography because Gabe's a night photography guy.
That's right. I should be sleeping right now, actually.
He actually should because he – dude, you're a good guest. You can come on this show anytime. I love it when guests just go, like a lot of times when we have a new guest, I get to brief him. I didn't get to brief him, but I always say, you know what makes a good guest on the grid?
Fresh.
One that talks.
Fresh.
One that talks. One that's fresh and sassy. I never mentioned the fresh and sassy part. I do want to mention something cool. I don't know if you know about this because this is so top secret and deep, deep in there.
Okay.
A brand new plugin came out today. It's for Lightroom. It's also for Photoshop, but I think of it as a Lightroom plugin.
Okay.
We're going to have a little sneak peek. I did a first look video. It was just released today, and it is a portrait retouching plugin for Lightroom or for Photoshop, but I still think of it as a Lightroom plugin. It's really good, and I'm going to give you just a 4-minute sneak peek of it after the commercial.
Okay.
I don't know if you know this, we do commercials.
Yeah.
You know what they're about? Mostly you.
Okay.
It's mostly different things about Gabe.
I'm
like,
ready.
We have one about what's his favorite hair care product. Where does he buy his hats? Right. You do have cool hats. You have a lot of cool hats.
I brought a new one out. For the show, yeah.
Is that Stetson? Is it a real Stetson?
Yeah, it is. I'm not going to take it off because they don't come off.
Yeah, once they're on, they're like, they're screwed on. He screws them.
You know what a top question I get, though, is?
What's that?
What hat do I wear at night?
Yeah, what hat do you wear?
Like when I go to bed? A nightcap, of course.
All right, I'm off the
take
show.
A good, yeah, I was going to say, take a good look at Gabe, because he went from hero to zero in 30 seconds. Hey, so I'm hoping that on the break, I'm pretty sure on the break they're going to show like a trailer, official trailer for your class.
Okay.
Now, your trailer was shot. You did it here in New York, didn't you?
We filmed in New York, yeah. Three locations.
Yeah, you did three different locations and stuff. People love that class.
I love that class. It was so much fun working with your team.
Did you work with Juan?
I worked with Juan.
He's magic.
He is magic Juan.
He is magic Juan. He's awesome. Anyway, we're taking your questions and comments. Look at this. Donna Kay says, looking forward to meeting Scott Kelby on April 11th. In the Detroit area.
Yeah. There's that thing
dude,
again.
What is that noise?
That's.
Oh, it's something back there?
No. It's coming. It's a notification on your phone.
Oh, it's a notification. I feel notified.
Yeah.
Anyway, wow. But thank you for mentioning that, Donna. And since you brought it up.
What?
I will be in Detroit on April 11th. Actually, just in Livonia, which is a suburb of Detroit. And we're going to have a lot of fun. We got a lot of photographers signed up for that seminar. So it's Lightroom all day.
Right.
Morning
the
till night.
The Burke Manor room.
At Burton Manor. Yeah, you know
love
it.
That. That's like
you
my favorite. Burton.
Yeah,
favorite
it's the only convention center in America in a formal funeral home, right?
Well, it's got couches.
It does. And you go in couches. There and you just feel the sadness. I don't think it's really.
No, but
it looks like a funeral. No, it wasn't really. But you go in there, you go. Dude, this thing is two weeks from a funeral home. If you decided I'm buying this place and making it a funeral, it's already got those leather, those velvet couches that look like sadness, like the
crying
couches.
Well, the vendors get to sit on the couches instead of the chairs. I appreciate that.
He does, but you know? The rest of us. All right, hey, look at this. Dallas Lombard says, hello from Knoxville, Tennessee. Gabe's class on KelbyOne changed my life.
Wow. Thank you, Dallas. That's
very, very nice.
That's awesome.
And Susan says, hi, Scott. I'm listening from the photo department at B&H.
Get us over there.
Can you get us over there? Now, we talked about this. Now, Meredith is back in the headquarters in Tampa. She's in the control room. And I'm just going to put this out there because I don't know if we're going to do it. We talked about taking a long break during the show and actually walking over to the store. And, like, we don't know. You know what we're worried about? Internet connectivity.
Yep.
So we may not do it. Yep. But we wanted to kind of just go, hey, here's the store. But then if all of a sudden we go blank in the middle of the show, you leave. Then there's that. So we have concerns about internet connectivity. However, can I tell you something? That phone is not connected to the internet via a Wi-Fi. It's cellular. We are broadcasting via cellular.
All right. So
it could work.
It could.
So,
except for that one dead zone. We can't go there.
There is a dead zone, right. So we're just gonna pose this question to Meredith, and Jen can pass it on. If we were to leave here and go to this – oh, no. God, they're already like, don't go to the store. I'm telling you, if you've never been to B&H, it's the greatest camera store in the world.
And I'll tell you, if we go there, we're there for an hour at least. It's just
– Yeah.
You know.
After? At the end.
At the end.
Oh, okay. We'll do that. Stick with us. We're going to go over there at the end of the show.
Bonus time.
Bonus time. All right. Any other comments here? Let's see. Robin says, can't wait to see Scott in Livonia. Boom.
Ooh, Livonia is trending.
Dude, Livonia. Hashtag Livonia.
Right. Wow.
It's trending.
When is Livonia trending?
I love this guy.
This is the first time
I'm moving to Livonia. I'm buying
property. Everybody's moving to Livonia. It's hot. Dive Photo says, I'm excited about Photoshop World in just a few weeks. We're, I think, 22 days away from Photoshop World Orlando. It's not too late to come. You know who's going to be there? Gabe.
Both of us.
Me, both of us leaves. Together.
Yeah.
Not at the same time, but, you know,
different rooms. One comes, the other one must leave.
Yeah. Yeah, there it is. Do it at the end. Okay.
All right.
Guys, we're going to do it. We're going to walk over with an unstable camera.
Yeah.
No, this is the iPhone 7 Plus that has video stabilization, which doesn't work in Skype.
Well, bear with us. It'll be a shaky adventure.
Yeah, but we're going to have to go through, like, the streets of New York and stuff. And we're right outside. How long do you think it is walking time from here to the door?
Well, it's a half a block, so I would have to say at least 20 minutes.
No, we're walking. We're not driving. Driving, it's 20 minutes, no doubt. Let me tell you. All right, I do want to mention this for people who know New York. I just wanted to say something. Last night, Keen Steakhouse.
Oh, I love it. The pipes up on the
pipes were on the roof. And today for lunch, Carmine's on West 44th.
Sick. Wow. Yep. Foodie heaven. Yep. Yep.
All right. Also, one more thing. I mentioned Jersey. I mentioned Joe from Jersey. Mm-hmm. You know who's going to be in Jersey? Frank Dorhoff. He only has 4 seats left in his workshop. It is coming up in New Jersey, and it is in some city in New Jersey. Somewhere in New Jersey.
Jersey is fairly small.
It's not Newark.
It's not Newark.
It's someplace else. The other city in Jersey is where it's at. I'm going to get you more details, but I do want to mention Frank's just got a few seats left. You ever taken a class from Frank? It'll curb your spine. All right, we're going to take a short break. When we come back, we're going to look at, they're going to give you a sneak peek of this plug-in. At the end of the show, we are going to go into the wild, wild world of sports and zoom over to B&H. And in the meantime, please enjoy our set.
Please, take a look around.
Take a look around. See what you think. It's different than the one we have at the headquarters, but it's a set nonetheless. We've got things to talk about Gabe's coat. We haven't talked about his coat or shirt yet. It's all been about the hat. There's more to Gabe than just a hat. He's a multi-dimensional guy. We are so glad you're here with us. We're going to take a short break. We'll be right back live here on The Grid. Don't go away.
See ya.
Hey, Rick Salmon here. Thanks for joining me. I hope you can really check out my latest class here, my 14th class here on KelbyOne. It's called 20 Time Proven Rules of Composition. Now, before you write me the email, oh, Rick, there are no rules. That's true. These are really recommendations. You'll learn how to break the rules. You'll also learn about some of my photo philosophies. But when it comes down to it, remember that composition really is the strongest way of seeing. So again, I hope you enjoy the class. I'm Rick Salmon. I'll see you online.
Well, hi everybody, Scott Kelby here. I want to tell you about my brand new class. It's called the 7-Point System for Lightroom. So this is a system I actually developed years ago. It was one of my best-selling books called the 7-Point System for Photoshop. But today, Lightroom is our workflow, and I've updated the 7-point system to how we use Lightroom and how we use this system today with all the latest stuff. You're gonna learn exactly what to do, when to do it, and exactly why to do it. The great thing about it is, it's just 7 things. Once you know these 7 things, you'll be able to look at every image, you'll be able to know what to do first, what to do next, what to do last. You got finishing moves and the whole 9 yards. Go to KelbyOne.com. Take the 10-day free trial and watch this class right now. It will change the way you work in Lightroom forever. And you'll find this class exclusively at KelbyOne.com.
Hello, my name is Gabriel Biderman. And in this video, Night Photography, it is my hope to inspire you to capture as well as create better images once the sun goes down. I'm gonna go over all the tools that you'll need, as well as share a ton of techniques that'll keep you more proficient in the field. We'll also experience a variety of nocturnal scenarios, from the cityscapes to the stars. And I'm gonna lay a solid foundation of lessons that'll keep you clicking well into the night.
We're back, right? Are we live?
We're back. Yes, we're live. Yes, we're live. When they go 5, 4, 3, that's like our cue. Okay. Anyway, good to have you guys here. Scott Kelby here with Gabe Biderman. And we are somewhere deep inside B&H. This is the interrogation room. This is where we go to people and we look at them and go, so do you have a Canon
or Nikon?
Right? What do you shoot? Do you shoot Canon or Nikon?
I shoot it all.
Do you?
I shoot it all.
He shoots it
all.
That's such a great answer. Ask me what I shoot.
What do you shoot?
I shoot it all.
So there you go. You shoot with fenders.
Oh, all Canon cameras.
Canon cameras.
No. I shoot a little bit of everything. I do. Look at this. So Kathy Bateson from Ireland. Hi, Kathy. Just Richard say, I just watched class with Scott on One Flash. Broke down and bought the Westcott Octa, 26-inch Octa. Bought the 2600 with a beauty dish plate, worth every penny, both the KelbyOne membership and the Octa. It gives great lighting. Got some beautiful butterfly lighting. Thanks, Scott. You're welcome. Just Richard. Hi from Australia, from Rob. Stephanie. So Stephanie has been on this round the world tour, but now she wants to come to New York. She goes, I watched Scott. If I won the lottery, I'd rent a U-Haul truck, drive to B&H, and just shop until I drop. At the end of the day, you'll find me passed out, curled up in the fetal position, happily clutching a new Canon 5DS while the B&H people load my truck.
That's no problem. If she does that, I will meet her there personally.
Raymond says, I spent so much money at B&H, I'm surprised I'm still married. It's just so easy for me to get there because I live in the Bronx. Oh, well, there you go.
Doesn't have to worry about those brown boxes being delivered.
No, that's right. There you go. Jim says, are there any seats available in Detroit on April 11th? If so, how do we get one? Go to KelbyOneLive.com. There are some seats available. We will usually sell seats until it's sold out. So if you get it now, you'll be okay.
Livonia is still trying.
And Robert Norris says, Scott and Gabe, what a team. Thank you. You're very kind. All right. So we want to take your questions about night photography. But so, Gabe, I want to start off by asking you, because, I mean, night photography is your thing, which is, you know, why you write books on it, do classes like that, on it, and stuff like that. And all. If you had to give somebody the main tip, like, okay, so if a buddy came to me and said, hey, tomorrow night, I want to go shoot a carnival. I want to go shoot, like, a fair. Mm-hmm. You know how those are always popular for night photography. What would be the one tip you needed? Like, here's what I would do. I would certainly make sure that I – Sure. Is it an accessory? Is it a camera technique? What is it?
Well, first, I definitely have to ask them if they're shooting with or without a tripod. You could do it either way. You know, there's not – you just do different things with different ways. You know, but if you're having a tripod, you can experiment with shutter speeds. You can experiment with time much more and go longer, right?
I saw it on your photo tip Friday. Right. You did a very good photo tip Friday. And that's what – and I remember you saying that, and I never thought about it in that way. If you're on a tripod, you can experiment with time.
Yeah. So now if you're not on a tripod, my one cool tip that I really like sharing, because it's everyone should know it, but we're like, oh, yeah. And that's go into your continuous burst mode in the camera and then just fire away. You know, because you can usually shoot anywhere. Depends what lens, how heavy your camera is, how stable you are. But, you know, put yourself.
How stable you are.
Turn yourself into a tripod, maybe even lean against something and go into that continuous shooting mode. And fire off 10, 15, 20 shots, however many shots you might be able to get off. The first three or four are going to be are not going to be sharp because you'll be moving because you're triggering. But once you kind of steady yourself, then the middle ones will be sharp and you'll have something.
Now, are these are going to be exposures that go like click, click.
Well, I would say, click, again, not click, probably not that, that slow, but more like click, 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 click. I can do it usually up down to like a quarter second. But this is going to where we can kind of, usually what we're told is to have a shutter speed, usually the equivalent of what focal length our lens is. So if we're shooting with 100 millimeter, we should be shooting at least
a hundredth of a second,
right? So if we want to get below, and 60th of a second is really the maximum shutter speed we should be shooting with any camera with a smaller lens. But if we want to get below 60th of a second, and I can usually go down to a quarter second, again, depends what the configuration is, then that's the trick to do it.
Okay. Hey, some questions are coming in for you here, Gabe.
Yep.
So, Gabe, do you ever use a gradation ND filter at night? Do you any of you use like a neutral density filter, something like that?
I generally – the only time – I don't use a graduated neutral density unless I'm doing landscapes during sunset.
Right, but after dark.
But once we're now at astro, you know, at that astro twilight, once we've passed that, we're at night. The light is even except where the moon goes.
Right.
And I really actually, I don't use any because it's dark enough. The only time I will use a solid ND
right.
is when I want to do car trails, you know, cityscape sort of car trails.
Oh, so you will do an ND filter for that?
I'll do a full ND, you know, when I'm in Vegas, when I'm in New York City, and I want to just extend those trails even more. There's no graduated needed per se, but right. I can just extend all the time.
For those of you who are kind of new to this, what an ND filter does, it fools your camera into thinking it's darker outside. Actually, it doesn't fool it. It makes it darker outside. It does. You're basically putting a big black plate of glass in front of your lens, and it just makes things darker. And it makes it darker, and that forces your shutter to stay open longer, or allows you, if you're in manual mode, to keep your lens open longer so your trails last for a longer time.
Yeah.
But how many stops do you use? Because you can get like a little bit darker,
yeah.
a bunch darker. Crazy darker. How many stops?
So I try to bring with – I have a high-tech filter system, and I usually bring with a 3-stop, a 6-stop, a 10-stop. I have a 16-stop as well, but that's usually for daytime use.
Yeah. 16-stop.
Have
you tried the Hiata filters?
Hiata.
H IADA?
I haven't.
Dude, you know they sell them here at B&H.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
I'll have to go check.
They're amazing. No, let me tell you about them. A buddy turned me on to these when I was on vacation, and he was using this system. It's real glass, so it's not plastic.
Sure. Nope.
It's real glass, and they're made in China.
Okay.
And they are about half the price of everything else, but they're so well made, right?
Yeah.
Am I right? You know these?
No.
No? No. Oh, you're looking them up. All right. Seriously, they're
like a flash sale on them.
The quality of them is surprising. It really is, because it is literally, I'm not kidding, it is half the price of some of the more famous ones.
Right? Lee is a top, you know, is a notorious.
You
got to
look at these.
Okay,
I'm telling
you. I'll check them out.
H A I D A. Filters, their NDs, and they make grads, and they have step downs. So you tell, you have to, when you order it, you go, this is going to be for a 24 to 70 Canon or a Nikon, whatever.
Are these the screw ins or the drop downs?
They're drop downs. You have a thing that attaches to the lens, and then it tightens on, and then you drop them in.
Yeah, your filter holder.
Who is so nice. That's it. There they are right there. You guys,
They look like a square box.
Likewise. Yeah. But can I tell you something?
Yeah.
It's all like, and here's another thing, and it's going to sound silly because I care about things like this. I'm just going to tell you, because I'm a photographer, how it looks matters. The packaging, it all comes in and all. Yeah. It everything is done like a very, very, like you think you're paying way more than double because it comes, you're like,
I like good packaging.
It's, well, it says something about the product. Yeah. Like, you know, what Steve Jobs used to have a saying. I read in a book a quote of his. I'm going to be paraphrasing here, but, they were talking about, if you're a great craftsman and you make a cabinet, do you finish the sides that no one sees?
Right.
Do you finish the underside? He says a great cabinet maker does. But you can say, well, nobody will ever see that. It doesn't matter, a great cabinet maker. Mm-hmm. Well, that's how you package it has a psychological effect about how you feel about the product. That's why Apple goes, even to this day, what's the first thing you do when you open an Apple product? It says, designed in California. It tells you, we care so much about the design. We designed it ourselves, and we want to talk about our design before you even open the box. It's like you take off the lid, and there it is, designed in Cupertino by Apple. But that stuff matters.
I tell you something. I did some spring cleaning this weekend, and I threw away a bunch of boxes I was saving, you know, just in case I need to send it back to the vendor. There's a bunch of photo, all these boxes. The most difficult boxes to break down were the Apple boxes.
Because they're made to last a million years.
Like, I was jumping on them.
All right, more question. Gabe, this is from Jock's photo. Jock's in Hawaii, so.
Right.
Gabe, do you use photo pills? I don't even know what photo pills
are. Love photo pills.
What are photo pills?
Photo pills is probably the best app out there.
I thought it was a drug.
No, it's a.
I thought you're out there shooting, you're like, I need some photo. Oh, where are my photo pills?
I become super photographer. No, but I'm a big fan of photo pills.
You're going to tell us what they are, aren't you?
So it's a great it is a multifaceted app. It is a dense app, I will say. And it's a $10 app. And right now it's for iOS only. But I think by the middle of the year, they'll have something for the droids out there. But it's great for – you can drop a pin anywhere and see where the sunrise, sunset. You can see where the Milky Way is going to be. So it's a great scouting app. And it has this great augmented reality aspect where, again, you can drop the pin anywhere and you can see where that – for me, I love it. I can see where that Milky Way is going to be, when it's going to stand straight in the air, when it's going to arc across. So for me, that is a great way for me to do my research for night photography, but great for landscape photographers, anyone who's doing any sort of like that where the twilight, morning light, evening light, any of that stuff's important, PhotoPills rocks.
There you go. $10?
$10.
Now, $10 in the world of photography is nothing. Nothing costs $10. But when you say an app, it's like $10 for an app?
Yeah.
Apps are 99 cents or free.
Exactly.
$10 my head wants to explode.
Yep.
All right. But a lot of questions coming in.
Okay.
This is an interesting one. Do you feel safe in cities at night?
Well, I'll tell you something. My wife kind of laid out a mandate early on when I was starting to do the night photography. And she says, I don't want you shooting alone. I don't care how big you are. And, you know, she's
like, you're huge. And you're I'm very scary.
The guy's huge. He's huge. He's from the city. And so I don't shoot alone. You know, I love the camaraderie of night photography because when you do night photography and you're doing these long exposures, you often have time to hang out. Too. Yeah. It's like I'm waiting for a time lapse that's going to be an hour. I'm going to waiting for a star track, you know, a star stack or something like that. So you have time to actually hang out. And it's a great, you know, photo experience. Plus, I love the challenge of multiple photographers going to the same spot and being able to come away with different images. That's to me, and we can share that because everyone sees the world differently. So that's a great way and a great challenge for us all.
All right. Die Photo asks, Gabe, which controller would you recommend? Now, they put up three of here.
Okay.
Or four. Cam Ranger.
Mm-hmm.
Wi-Fi Fei.
Okay.
X Stories. Or five, actually. Jopic or Cam Buddy.
Okay.
Jopic. Z-O-O, I don't know.
You know, Jopic? I personally have just used the shutter releases that just plug in directly into the camera.
Yeah, me too.
And triggers it that way. The Velo Shutter Boss system, it's inexpensive from either $10 to $50. That's a great, it has all the features inside there. Obviously, the only one of those that I'm actually even familiar with is the Cam Ranger, which B&H has been selling for many years. And that's a great, you know, way to, that you can kind of on, you know, your phone or your iPad, you can control things from there. But here's the thing. I'm always sensitive about draining batteries because that's the big caveat to night photography is nothing drains your camera batteries more than long exposures. You know, so I'm always very conscious of the batteries I have. And so if I'm going to now add the phone, and plus, looking at that big screen also, especially when we're in rural night photography, it blinds us, right? When we look at that screen, then we look out, I can't see the stars anymore. So that's my two cents.
There you go. Who is VJM says, wish I knew about photo bills, pills before buying the Ephemeris.
Well, Ephemeris is, that's the two competing ones. And Ephemeris was out there first. And Ephemeris is really, really good. It doesn't have, I think you have, it's an add-on to buy the augmented reality of the Milky Way. But it gives you all the other things. I just like the layout of photo pills. They're very similar, and I believe they're both $10. I actually have them both. And I tried and played with them both, and I've just kind of leaned towards the ease of use of the photo pills.
Hey, Miroslaw asks, what about the color cast of these Chinese filters, especially in denser versions? This is what I liked best. This was the thing that really sold me on it.
Okay.
I've got a 10-stop, and I stack a 3-stop with it.
Uh-huh.
13 stops, Gabe.
Yeah, you're almost to my 16.
That's a lot of stops. That was the thing, the color integrity of them. Because I have a bunch of different ones. And I've got screw-on ones. I've got drop-in ones, very popular ones. They always have a color cast.
It's tough.
Dude, I cannot tell you how clean. I can show you raw images taken, untouched, and the color fidelity is the best I've ever seen.
That's impressive, because that's something they've all struggled with.
I read a review of it. Somebody wrote a review on them, and you can go look them. If you type in IATA filters review, and somebody wrote, is this the filter that kind of changes everything? Because it takes the price, you know, it's just like what Uber has done to taxis and things, where something comes to the market mm-hmm. and it changes everything. That's the question they posed was, at this price with this quality and this fidelity, is this the product that changes the market?
Sure.
So it's pretty big. Let's see what else. UF Photography says, I find it stupid that the DA10 doesn't support a wireless remote. My D7000 does, and it's half the price. But you know what? It's not just the DA10. It's a number, all the high-end cameras. Because you know what you can get a wireless remote for a Nikon D7000 for? $12?
Yeah.
It's like $12. You know what the wireless remote for a 1DX is or a Nikon D5?
It's like $300.
Yeah, it's like $300.
Well, you got to move those much, they're more refined files. They're moving.
Yes, the files are much more refined, very large. Large files. So Just Richard says, shutter speeds have always eluded me for night photography. I use a tripod,
okay.
but I can never seem to get good night shots without blur. If I shoot faster, then it's too dark. If I shoot slower, then it's streaked / blurred. Any tips? I appreciate any suggestions. Would you want to know if Richard's using a tripod?
Well, it seems like he is. But here's the trick. I guess, you know, you're right. If you're just... you have to have something solid, you know, something solid that is kind of the foundation of the shot. So if we're shooting car trails, you know, make sure there is some sign, maybe a row of palm trees or just something there that stays solid. If it's just going to all be a blur, it's hard to look at, right? That's very, very hard for our brain to process. So the key to night photography, and especially think of all of those river shots, those like silky, smooth or river shots, what makes those, you know, really stand out is like the rocks in the water that you can now see the water, that smooth water rushing across, as well as the trees and everything along the side. So we need, when we're going to have movement in there, it's emphasized by something solid.
I'm sorry, Gabe. I got so bored, I tuned out.
Thanks.
I'm just kidding. No, I'm looking. I'm doing some research here on B&H's site.
I was going to ask you how to spell Haida.
H-A-I-D-A. So the reason I'm looking is because somebody said here, and they're very right. So Kenny says, you know, I don't want to – what would be a good ND filter to start with to see if I actually use them? I don't want to spend $500. Well, exactly.
I would use Haida filters for sure.
So the Haida filter, I'm looking at the 10-stop. The 10-stop filter itself is $129. Now, this is a high-quality filter. Now
– you have to buy the holder, too.
You have to buy the holder. That's why I'm looking for the holder. And it's in the eye of the beholder.
It is in the eye of the
– I'm still looking for the holder.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
Holder's $2,400. No, I'm just kidding. I haven't found the holder yet. I'm still looking. Now, what's nice is once you have the holder, you can drop different filters in. You can do a graduated neutral density. Mm-hmm. You can do a 3-stop. You can do a 10-stop. It lets you stack a one on top of another.
So you can stack 3 or 4.
Yeah.
You know,
it's. I think you can stack.
And you have to always be aware of, really wide lenses. Things below, wider than 24 millimeter, they might need special adapters. So really, we're talking when you're using the filter system, 24 millimeter and beyond.
All right. So we're talking probably 125 for the kit.
Okay. Well, so that's for the 15 to 30. That's a super wide one.
Right.
So that's probably a little bit more expensive.
Well, I was going to see if I can find another one. I'm still searching.
Okay.
I accidentally hit the button. I didn't mean to actually go.
You saw the
that.
Picture. You were.
I got excited. Yeah. Yeah. Well, here's one
now
for
that's a 15-32. Keep going. There we go. $99.99.
$99. All right.
Bucks.
Yeah. There we go.
Who doesn't have $100 to throw at a filter?
Who doesn't have $100 now? So you're really talking, let's say $250, but it's half of the price, half of the $500, right? So, and you can buy cheaper ones, but can I tell you something? If you that's a really good price for a whole system.
That's a great price.
Because if you buy a cheaper one and you don't get good results and the color's all tinged and it's weird, mm-hmm. and there's tremendous vignetting and all, you're going to go, it's not for me.
You'll be turned off from long exposure photography forever. And that will make me cry.
Long exposure photography is amazing, and that will make Gabe cry.
You don't want to see that.
There will be an uncontrollable crying. Hey, so we got a lot of good questions, yay. But before we do that, I mentioned that when we came back from the break, we were going to look at that new plugin.
Okay.
So here's my thing. I haven't used a lot of plugins. There's only been one plugin that I found was pretty reasonable for skin. I learned about it from Frank Dorhoff, and it's the Portrait Pro. It actually does a pretty good job. I want to make sure I'm giving you the right one. From Imagenomic, Portraiture, and it's pretty good. And so that's the one I've used up to this point. And I never used a plugin for doing skin. I always did it myself in Photoshop, mm-hmm. the old-fashioned way, the hard way.
With the rocking chair.
So then this plugin came out, Portraiture, and Frank turned me onto it. And of the ones I've seen, I like this best.
Okay.
But I got to say, there's a new champ in town. So Perfectly Clear has been around a little while. Mm-hmm. They're a plugin, and they've been doing like some retouching stuff. What makes their thing best is the math. Like their math behind it is better, but I have a little video for you. I did. It's just like 4 minutes, and I'm going to take you through some of the features, and then we'll talk a little bit about it. I think of all the ones I've ever seen so far, this is the best.
Okay.
This is one that I actually used it yesterday to use it, not to demo it, not because I wanted. I was like, ooh, I can use that plugin. And one of the things it has that I really like is it has a strength amount for everything. Like it'll say, let's auto do this photo. Can I tell you something? I've never seen a plug-in when you hit an auto button that you don't go, that's too much.
Yeah.
The skin looks plastic, it looks fakey, whatever. This looks on the edge of that, like, ooh, but there's a little strength slider. And when you move the strength slider, it does all the math. In other words, it just doesn't drag the sliders. It says, this one has to move a half a stop, and then this only has to move 4, and then this, you know, for everything to move mathematically mm-hmm. the right amount.
Okay.
Anyway, watch the video. We're going to show it to you here. And again, it just came out today. I think you can go download a demo version and try it for yourself. Very clever stuff in here. So take a look. So here is Perfectly Clear Complete. And I look at it as a portrait retouching tool. Now, it will do more than that, but I'm just telling you how I look at it.
as a portrait retouching tool. And yes, there's a bunch of different ones out there, but I think the math behind this one is, I think of the ones I've ever used, I think this one is hands down the best. Take a look at the picture here. Here's the before and here's the after. You can look at either a split view here or the side-by-side right here. And you can see it's done a pretty nice job. So the things that it has done, they've added in this new version, besides a completely new interface, gathering everything together like perfect skin and perfect eyes and all into one interface, so you're not moving between different ones. They have face selection. So it uses facial recognition technology to figure out where the face is. But you can also manually add. This is brand new. You can manually add. You just say, here's the left eye, here's the right eye, and it pretty much gets the rest. You have a lot of enhancement stuff, of course, for the eyes. Enlarge the eyes. Reduce dark circles, which it does really, really well. You have face contouring here, which kind of changes the width of the face. You've got teeth whitening, lip sharpening. You've got, and this is nice. Like when you're doing a skin softening, you can say just do the face only or do the full body. So that's, it doesn't, because a lot of plugins that do like skin smoothing or things, they're going to smooth the hair. They're going to smooth everything. They're not using that kind of technology where this one actually says, just do the face. Another new thing that they added, I think, is pretty cool. If you go down a little further, is makeup. So they actually have, you can add foundation, you can add blush, and you can see I added a little bit to the cheeks here. You can choose different, if you click on the icon, you can choose different types of blush, different types of foundation. There is a overall skin toning. So it really has a lot to it. Of course, it's got presets over here. You go under the essentials, they've got different ones, this intelligent auto. Now, the thing about this is, and I would say this, I've never met a skin softening plugin that I didn't think overdid it, all right? So there is this strength slider, and when you move the strength slider, it moves, it reduces everything. It's kind of like undo on a slider, but it does it mathematically correct for all the sliders. So it's not moving them all -5, it moves them in the right increments. So by backing this off to like 70%, I think it looks just a whole lot better. But that's just in that particular one. They have a Beautify, which does a bunch of different automated looks. They have Beautify Plus, which is the next level of it. But again, I think it's just a little bit too much, and you can back it off here, no problem. They fix noise. They fix dark photos. They do have landscapes. Now, it does landscapes. You can open up a landscape shot, click the button, click the Intelligent Auto Enhance, or click Vivid. Vivid is a very vivid look, and it does look better. And I know they'll probably kill me for saying this, but I still see this as a heads-up retouching tool. Like, if you want to retouch bridesmaids and things like that, and you want to get it done really quickly, and you don't want to break a sweat, you don't have to be a retouching expert. Of every plugin I've ever used, I think this one does the best job for all the like portrait retouching stuff. I think it is far and away, the math behind it is the best. The interface is much, much better. And they've added a lot of things. Like, for example, they've added like lip sharpening is a new one. They have regular sharpening, but they have lip sharpening up as well under the facial. Where is it? Right down here. Oh, and catch lights. You can add your own. Now, she has catch lights from a beauty dish, so we're not going to add a little light underneath. So we're not going to add them, but they've got catch lights. You can try, you know, do you want these to come from an umbrella, a ring light, a softbox, a beauty dish, outdoors, whatever you want. And there is a lot of automation, but what I like about it is you can then turn on a checkbox and kind of back things off or increase things. I haven't done a lot of increasing. I've done a bit of back it off, but the shine removal and things like that, if you've got like too much shine, it does a nice job of backing that off if you've got hot spots or oily skin. I think they just did a really good job with it. So I'm going to dig more into it on my blog and go into some of the other things, just like all the Beautify settings and these other ones. And I'll do that in some of, I'll go into some of the eyes and skin and stuff. But that's for another day. But today I just wanted to, it just came out today, and I just wanted to give you a quick peek here on the grid of Perfectly Clear Complete 3. You can go download the beta and try it yourself and kind of check it out. They've also got a really good deal on it now, too. If they're doing like a order it now and save a bunch of money deal. So anyway, go check it out. Perfectly clear, complete version 3. So there's your grid sneak peek.
We're back. Hi. Okay. So anyway, give that thing a look. So you know who really made me really, because I like it. I've used it before, but I use all the little different components like clear eyes and stuff. You know why I started using clear eyes? Because Christina Shirk, she makes her living as a high-end retoucher. So she's like,
sure.
Their eye thing is pretty good. I mean, she's like, yeah, I use their eye thing. Like, I don't know what they're doing with their thing that gets rid of, like, you know, the dark circles and stuff. It's like, it's good. It's like, I don't know what they're doing. So I do say this, hats off to their engineers. They're doing some really, really good stuff. Now, you could say, well, you can do all that stuff in Photoshop. You sure could. But this thing's really fast, and you can use presets. And you know what it is? There will be times that you will want to still do it all in Photoshop. Like if you're doing a really close-up portrait, it's like the hero shot, you might want to just go, I'm going to go old school and do it that way. But if you're doing like 8 bridesmaids, bang, 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 done, save as. So anyway, it's worth trying the demo and giving them a look, and congratulations to them. I think they've done a pretty good thing. Somebody asked here, is it a Lightroom or a Photoshop plugin? I use it in Lightroom. It's also a Photoshop plugin, so I have it applied to Photoshop as well. I believe, don't count me on this, but I think you can also use it as just a standalone, just kind of open it up.
What about for aperture?
I don't know. That's it. Off the set. Hey, so let me just tell you just a little aside here. So in a few minutes, we're gonna leave and go to the store and kind of walk around. Now, we're wearing these lab mirror mics, these long cords, and so our producer here on the scene, he says, You're gonna walk over there with all these cords dangling and stuff. And we're like, yeah, goes, yeah, nothing can go wrong there. So this is a lot.
So expect nothing to go wrong.
Yeah. So expect nothing, comma, to go wrong.
Yeah.
Some more questions. Joe's asking, when shooting star trails,
yes,
do you prefer a large aperture or a small one? And does it really make a difference?
It does. It actually does make a difference. So the wider open the aperture, so 2.8 f/4, the more stars you'll see. Okay, so even there, you know, our eyes can see X amount of stars, and it all depends how the moon is out there, how bright it is, how dull it, or how not bright it is, you know, new moon, full moon. But the wider open you are, the more stars you will record on your camera. I never stop down more than F8. And a lot of people think that sweet spot is like 5.6, because there is the thing where you can have just too many stars, and again, it's hard for our brains to just see that many. If we're creating this epic star trail, you'll see there'll be just too many stars trail. So try it at f4, 5, 6.
So which is it, f4 or 5 or 6?
4 or 5.6.
I was just messing with you. Dave Clayton's in the house that says, good evening, fellow. Hey, Mr. Clayton. Do you know Dave Clayton?
I know a lot of Daves, but the Clayton is eluding me.
He's from the UK.
Okay.
And he's a streaker, just professional, like runs naked for money. Yeah, that's all he does. Yeah. But I will say, like, you know, I'm going to say that you are New York's Dave Clayton, because Dave Clayton is like a wonderful ambassador for all of the UK. He's one of the greatest guys. He's a very smart guy, very funny. You're like that for New York.
Except I don't streak.
And you're not funny. Okay. All right. Let's see what else we got here. Ian says, thanks for the three-leg thing tripod recommendation, Scott. I'm so happy now. Cheers. You guys sell the B&H?
The three-legged. Those three-legged are fun tripods.
Dude, those are great. They're so clever. I love when stuff is clever.
And made in the UK, I believe.
No, designed in the UK.
Made where else?
Someplace else. China? I don't know. Singapore? I don't know. All right. Let's see. Okay, so Fernando...
Okay.
Hey, Fernando. I think that's the Fernando from Portugal.
Okay.
Says, confirmed. It also works as an external editor for photos for Mac. It works as a sternal photo for Aperture and Capture One.
Aperture.
Who'd have thunk it?
Who would have talked about that?
Will Taylor wants to know, what's a good white balance for star trails? Gabe.
Wow. It really all depends the scenario. Obviously, if we're doing star trails, we're probably out of the city lights. And a good starting point, you know, it really depends how many light sources are out there. If we get out to a national park or something like that where there's very little star trails, or very little light, then we could, I usually will go somewhere between 3,500 Kelvin and 4,000. What I often tell people a good starting point is the tungsten setting. Remember, the tungsten or incandescent icon is a light bulb. So it's a good idea to start with that.
1 second.
Okay.
I'm sorry, I just happened to send a message out there. Okay.
Yeah.
More questions. Mark asks, oh, wait a minute. This is Mark Wegner. You don't know who Mark Wegner is. Mark Wegner, this is somebody you should know. Mark Wegner is the guy that won our competition to have his gallery showing at the gallery at KelbyOne.
Wow.
He's the winner. He's the guy who's worked. Oh, that's Mark, and he's an amazing photographer. He asks, any tips for dealing with extreme low temperatures when you're shooting at night?
Right. Well, definitely. There is the battery, right? The battery drains quicker when colder temperatures.
And you're already draining the battery fast because you're doing long exposure.
And you're already draining because it's a long exposure. So definitely multiple batteries. Keep those spare batteries on your body. Like put it not, obviously if it's cold out, you're wearing multiple layers. So put it on one of the, put it in your, put it in one of your jacket pockets that's inside another one. So the warmer you keep that battery, we could be swapping them out and they're kind of, they gain back a little bit more juice. The warmer they are, you put them in, you might get 20 minutes with that one, 30 minutes with that one. Any use of an external battery pack, actually there's a great product that I love, love, love. It's by Tether Tools and it's the case relay system. Okay, and what you do
that's really nice. And this is the case.
The case relay is known for studio work, right?
Yeah, right.
The tethered studio work. But it is probably my number one favorite thing for night photography. You stick a dummy battery, that replaces the battery, goes into the case relay, which then will plug into any USB power pack. I use the one with Tether Tools, the rock solid one. It's a 10,000 milliamp battery pack. And I tell you something, Scott, I have used that for I've been shooting 4, 6, 8 hours. I haven't been able to drain it on a night shoot. I'd set it up at like 9 or 10 o'clock. I'd wake back up at 6 a.m. It's still got juice in it. It's amazing.
Here's a follow-up question. What about the lens getting moisture on it with the low temperatures?
So that's a tricky one. And here's some things you can get is, the professional thing to do is you can get these it's a strip that controls the temperature. You plug that into a battery pack and that'll kind of keep the temperature consistent. You can do that. The MacGyver way to do it is, you would need a nickel, a paper clip,
a matchbook.
You need really a rubber band, a sturdy rubber band, and maybe put some like hand warmers around it. So again, it stays that consistent temperature. You know, that's sort of the...
You put it around the lens?
You put it around the barrel of the lens. You
can really?
That's, yes. I have the professional strip. I use that.
Well, of course you do.
Professional.
Of course you do, Gabe. Well, of course. Let's see what else we got. We got that. We talked about that. Matt wants to know, when you're shooting night scenes,
mm-hmm.
how do you handle different color temperature lights? For example, sodium halide street lights with street lights and shines illuminated by fluorescent lights.
This is the tricky scene, there's definitely a couple examples, I believe, in the video and in my book. But here's the trick. Here we have, one of those oranges, so the sodium vapor, the oranges, lights on one side of the image. On the other side, we've got a mercury vapor. It's a greenish bluish light. How do you balance that? It's very impossible. I mean, obviously we could put a target in there, like an X-Rite color checker or any sort of gray card. What I found I did, is oftentimes, if there's a street sign or something, did not turn off. But if there's a street sign, the back of the street signs are gray too. So that can be used as a simple target.
I got a trick.
Yeah.
Ready?
Yeah.
I got a trick. You can go into Lightroom afterwards and paint white balance.
You can
actually go get the adjustment brush and you can paint with white balance and just you're gonna have to pick one. I'm gonna go with the street lights or I'm gonna go with this
Correct.
One. But you can make that match the other one. So if one's too blue, you'll paint away from the color blue, you'll paint towards yellow and warm it up. So honestly, rather than putting a color checker into your night scene and all, I'd freaking fix it in Lightroom.
I wanna talk about this for one more minute because I think it's a really interesting because we're seeing a lot of the street lights go to LED technology, which is a white, and I find that white light, as true as it might be, it's kind of boring, right? I love the sodium vapor lights. I think they're a wonderful characteristic light for night photography. So shoot them while you can and enjoy that.
Miroslav says, do you use any battery-powered fans to keep the moisture off your lenses? I saw them in use by astronomers on their telescopes.
Right, that is a popular tip for that. I have not put myself in those extreme situations, but I tell you something, I'm going to be in Florida leading a workshop with National Parks at Night, going to Dry Tortugas in July.
Dry Tortugas.
And
I've only been to the wet ones. So
I'm sure it'll be moist down there. The name is misleading. All right.
Let's keep reading. No, let's keep reading. Because we're about to make our trip over to the store. You don't want to leave now.
You want to
see how this is going to work. This is going to be interesting. So don't leave because we're leaving there. Because what will happen is we'll go to commercial and we'll go downstairs and then we'll go live at some point as we're walking down the street. Whoa. All right. And we're going to get a tour over there. I just want to ask a couple more questions.
Sure.
They're coming in. We're also getting some comments about the plug-in that I showed earlier. Let's see what we got here. Oh, Marie says, Gabe, I loved your night photography class.
Thank you, Marie,
for telling us that. Stephanie says, I had issues doing Milky Way shots in the south. A high dew point means glass fogging up easily.
Right.
That seems to be a common problem.
Yeah,
there.
Getting that dew strip around there, you know, obviously – if the temperature is consistently hot, then once that lens kind of gets up to that, here's the problem is when we take our lenses from the AC of the car or in the house and we go and take it outside, they're going to have condensation everywhere. So either don't put the AC on in the car as you're driving to your location, just have the windows open so it's kind of at that temperature already, or again, getting that sort of that dew strip around there to kind of, make sure that temperature.
All right, bunch of comments here. Thomas says, just bought the plug-in.
Boom.
Stephanie says, I'll download a trial and give it a whirl.
Why not?
Let's see, where were we? Mark says, how do you choose between black and white and color photos in the editing process?
Is that to me or to you?
That's to you.
Oh, that's to me? It's funny, I have been doing photography since the film days, and I love black and white. But it's so funny, now that I'm shooting digital, I love color. We always shoot in color for the most part. And then if the scene has that strong graphic sense to it, like, again, I'm going to go back to Dry Tortugas. Dry Tortugas is this fort, this massive fort on this island. And it just screamed, black and white on it. And I just did a blog, again, for National Parks at Night. And I just talked about my whole process of stacking those stars in color. And then I shifted to black and white because I thought, that had a better graphic representation.
Here's the truth. He just goes and downloads a stock photo. That's what he did.
That
works too. Hey, let's see. Somebody wrote, I can't wait to see how the walk to the store turns out.
Nor can we.
Next, our buddy, Nikki P. Yo, Nikki P. That's actually Nicholas Papagallo Jr.
Oh, we
Very
know
good,
Nick.
Good, yeah, we know Nick. Nick's a good guy.
Oh, he's one of the best.
He is. And he says, Gabe, great book. I recommend it when asked for tips.
Thank you, Nick.
You know, it's like a Gabe love fest today, really. And all right. So question for the guest. That's you, by the way. Stephanie from earlier has now forgotten your name and just calls you guest. So guest, have you used the exposed to the right method to overcome light pollution in the night sky? Do you know about the exposed to right thing?
Well, I mean, the way that I attack the scene when I'm shooting is, obviously with night photography, it's going to be heavy on the left.
Right.
Because it's a dark scene.
Of course.
But I try to get that hump obviously we don't want it squished all the way to the left.
Right.
We want to have some detail in there. And I definitely overexpose, I think, a little bit more. Depends, again, full moon, I'll overexpose a little bit more. When it's no moon, I'll overexpose less. But I'll usually overexpose one stop to get that hump more to the middle.
Okay.
You know?
So you don't like to clump, but you do like to hump.
Yeah.
Is that what you're saying?
That's a t-shirt.
That's the thing. There
that's
you go.
That's a t-shirt.
Wayne wants to know, what is the brand of the strip that you use to control condensation?
You know, send us an email and I'll get it back to you. I got it a few years ago and I got it from what did we call that app that I love that I'm now spacing on?
The one that you said earlier?
Right.
I'll scroll back up
Hold
to
on.
It. What's it called? It's not ephemeral.
It's the photo pills.
Photo pills.
If you Google, photo pills, astrophotography, they have a wonderful article on it.
People
and
are answering for you. Photo pills.
Thank you. But they have this strip and the battery pack. They have the whole thing in there. And I got it from there.
All right. Well, I think it's time to go to the store. I just think it is. I think we should try it. I think we should see what happens. I'm going to pack up some of my stuff now. Here's how this is going to go down. If we go and we lose signal or the security guards won't let us in, they'll let Gabe in. They'll be like, Gabe, come in.
Come in, come in, please.
But if anything weird happens, Meredith, who is our director back in the control room in Florida, will immediately either A, go to video, or B, decide the grid is over, and you'll see the ding, 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 like goodbye kind of thing. It could go either way.
I like now, the static going along the middle. I think that would be kind of cool.
Yeah, could be doing that. So we don't know where we're going to go. We're going to answer one last question. Will wants to know, do you incorporate bracketing for star and night photography? Do you bracket?
I do not.
He's a non-bracketing guy.
I work really hard. I take 10 or 15 shots to establish the exposure that I'm comfortable with. And then once I get that, I commit to it. And away we go.
But you know what he is? He doesn't bracket, but he does walk.
And we're going to see how well I walk with you.
Yeah.
Side by side, because we're tethered right now.
All right. So it looks like we're getting some control. Anything from the control room? They just said go for it and see what happens.
See what happens. All right.
All right, so we're going to walk over to the store, hopefully be able to give you a little tour around. Gabe knows the store like the back of his hand. He was actually born in the lighting department.
The little green bucket.
It's not true. He was actually born in the back seat of a Greyhound bus rolling down Highway 41. He was born a rambling man.
Born on a motorcycle.
I was born on a motorcycle. We're going to go over there, wish us luck, and hopefully in a few minutes now. You might see more commercials than normal right now, but it's all good stuff. Whatever it is, it's good stuff. Right. So, you know. All right. Are we ready to gather up our stuff? We're going to go for it.
Hopefully, when
we see you, we're going to be on the street. So, see you in a minute.
Cheers.
All right.
Hey, guys. My name's Peter Hurley, and you are here in my studio, and I am going to teach this class on the top 10 questions I get regarding headshot photography. So here's what you're gonna get. These are big ones, you ready? How do you chill out your subject? How do you get their good side? How do you take weight off of somebody that's a little bit heavier? How do you get glare out of the glasses? What about continuous versus strobe? I'm gonna go over those and many more in this class. Come join me on KelbyOne.com.
I've been here 4 times. I continue to learn new and fabulous things about photography and Photoshop and Lightroom.
If you come here with one thing on your mind, you're probably going to end up leaving with interest in other areas.
You want to stay in the know and stay on the cutting edge. This is the place to do it.
Anyone that has a passion for creative things, photography, design, they attend Photoshop World.
You know, I love modern cameras because of the autofocus system. They nail it so much of the time. But there are a lot of things that you can do, just little things that you can change in your camera that'll make autofocusing even better. And this is every camera out there that has an autofocus system. Well, I go through all of this in my latest KelbyOne class, All About Focusing. And it's a class that you guys said you wanted to know about. And I'm gonna take you through the various systems. I'll show you tips and tricks. We'll talk about zone focus and hyperfocal distance and other things that you never even thought you knew about. So we'll cover that in my latest class about focusing, only on KelbyOne.
Hey guys, Christy from Shark Pixel here, and come join me and my Shark Squad April 20th through 22nd in Orlando for Photoshop World before I get eaten! Hey guys,
okay, well,
Christy from Shark
the street.
Live from New York City.
B&H is right back there. There it is. You can see it over our shoulder. We're going to go walk to the store. We're going to go upstairs where all the fun stuff is. There's some moderate fun stuff downstairs, like lighting and stuff.
Some pretty good stuff.
Upstairs. Come on, we'll give you a tour.
All right.
So then. All right, well, we can still talk, right?
Yeah, we certainly can. So here's New York. This is what we call New York.
These are pedestrians.
These are pedestrians.
They rule the streets.
They rule the streets.
They rule the streets.
They stop traffic. They rule the streets.
Look, it's my favorite store.
Here we are.
I remember the first time I ever came to B&H, my whole life, Gabe was the guy that gave me the tour.
Yep. Takes up a full city block. So here we are at 34th. It runs all the way to 33rd.
Oh, yep. It takes a full city block. Two stories?
Two stories, 70,000 square feet.
70,000 square feet of camera love.
You want to ask me how many bags there are?
How many bags are there?
I don't know.
We're going to go look.
At least 500.
We're going to go look there for sure.
All right. This is the exit. A lot of people try to get in that way.
And that's why there's security guards.
That's why there's security guards.
All right.
But you want to go under the awning. Hopefully Pedro is there to greet us. Oh, right. I see Pedro. He's got the best hat. I defer to Pedro.
All right. Here we go.
Pedro!
Pedro, hey, man. How you doing? I like the hat.
How are you?
Hey,
how are you?
You're live.
You're live.
All right, guys, well, come on in.
So welcome to B&H. As you can see, the conveyor belt system, that's what we're sort of famous for. You can see that going on, and green
there
buckets.
All right, hi.
Exactly.
Okay, so the conveyor belt system, if you go up into the counter and you play with a camera or something and you decide that you want to keep it, what they do is they send it on these conveyor belts. They go all over the store. You'll see your camera go by and go, there it goes, that's my camera. And it goes over to the cashier so you can pick it up.
Hands-free shopping.
Hands-free shopping. You don't have to carry anything. It just goes around with you. All right, let's look back off a little bit. Sorry. Now we're going to go this way. Okay.
So there's Barry and Video over there. Look, we've got our own Empire State Building there. That's our pro video shootout. There he goes. The welcome to B&H. So this is the video section. We've got video. We got tripods. We got the cameras, the camera
video
shootout. And then we also have the audio section mixed in as well. So that's a... You know, because video and audio kind of go hand in hand. And look, we've got some.
We're watching.
Are you kidding me?
All right. You got to show the camera.
Yeah,
look, she's like watching.
This is like so meta.
This is like Inception when you're like watching the grid and then you're on the grid at the same time. Messed up.
All right, we're going to go where the good stuff is.
Thanks for coming.
But I see one of my buddies over here, so I got to go ahead and say hi.
What's up, man? Welcome. Hi.
Hi.
Hi, Gabe.
All right,
yeah.
This is Ali and Miriam, and I got to imagine you're only going to be in this country another week or two.
From Iran.
Yeah.
You know we can't last here very long, so.
Yep.
We're going to stand up for you, though, okay. Me and Gabe. We're vouching for you. Don't send him back. He's okay. He's an amazing photographer.
Thank you so much. Freaking amazing.
Last time I was here, we went to dinner.
Yes.
And he was showing me some of the stuff that he's done to New York City.
Is it public yet, or is it still all secret?
No.
The public.
All right.
You took it on my website.
He did these projects for Hasselblad.
Oh, nice.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable.
Thank you.
All right. Where's your website?
www.ali-rajabi.com. RAJABI.com.
So you can check it out. ALI-RAJABI.com. Yeah. You don't have to put in the www. That's old school. He's new to the internet. He's from a different country. But he's fully certified. Anyway,
okay.
go check. His stuff is amazing. And
Thank you.
He's a wonderful photographer. We met him years ago at Photoshop World in Orlando.
2010.
For 2010, and we've all been friends ever since. But
good seeing you, buddy.
Okay. Good to see you.
Thank you.
Good to see you.
Good to meet you. I'm checking out your site.
We're going to go upstairs.
All right. So we have the computer section down there. We have our very own Apple store here. But really, we want to get to the photo stuff. So we're going to go past here. You follow the green brick road. That's sort of the motto here.
Ooh, can we just real quick walk through lighting?
We can definitely walk through lighting.
We've got to walk through lighting. Is our connection okay still? As we're getting
deeper
in. All right, we're going to go up.
All right. So there's the lighting section. There's our guys.
At least pan over to the lighting section.
Give them a nice pan.
Just give them a nice pan.
Say hi, lighting.
Hi. How you doing?
All right, come on up.
I just come here so someone will recognize me. If I go to B&H, it's almost a lock. At least somebody will know me.
All right.
Sorry.
All right, we're going to go up the escalator to the second floor.
We're on the move. Look at this incredible camera work. Wait, you can back it off a little bit. Whoa, there you go. That was like a medical shot. You can see.
And when we get up here, we're going to be in our used department, because not only are we the world's largest reseller of new equipment, but also of used equipment. Sell us your used gear. Buy used from us. Save a little cash.
Save a little. Used. Now,
including the museum here.
Film photography.
Film photography.
Hey, look, there's a nice 600.
Yep. And an 800.
See the camo? If you use this, nobody can see you. Tip down there. Tip it down a little. Tip your camera down. There you go.
There you go.
Camo. You wear that and you disappear.
At least the animals won't see you.
The animals, no. Especially like bison.
Exactly.
So up here is the photography section. So when I come to the store, I just come in, I go straight at the escalator up to here. Now, if you've ever watched one of those presentations from B&H's event space, that happens up here to
right
your left.
Over here.
Yep. Anything going on in there?
I think it might be, we can peek in for sure, because there was something scheduled at 4, so I would think it's still going on.
Let's go see.
Let's go take a peek. It's dark in there. But here it is. It's Enid Farber, photographing jazz legends.
Yeah, there's a presentation going on there right now.
So you can always, if you're in New York, come to the event space, or you can also, we live stream a lot of them. All the way, there we go, boom. So really, really, really fun.
And now there's people gaming over here.
Yep, this is the gaming center. I brought my nephew here, and he was like, I don't want to go to B&H. He was like 9. He said, I don't want to go. And I brought him up here. I couldn't get him to leave. Sat in that chair, and no one else was able to sit in.
All right.
But are you ready? You ready?
Yeah, we're going to the camera section.
Okay.
Only took us like 6 weeks to get there. Are we still in B&H? Hey, dancing water speakers,
right? Who doesn't need those?
Everybody needs those.
All right, we're about to stand in the middle of the photo universe.
This is
come on, a little bit closer.
A little bit.
Isn't it have that wonderful like photo smell?
It really does. New photos. No. So let's start by panning over that way and let's just kind of go that way. All the way.
You can see all the salespeople that are behind those counter. You can go to that counter and you can try any lens on any camera, of course, that'll fit. And that's a great place where you can bring your own camera to try lenses with.
Come on down this way.
So.
Yeah, that's a good safe distance there. Keep way back from me in the hat.
So just look, for example, this is the tripod forest.
Look at this, the tripod forest. Just hit this over there.
I think there's probably at least 500 tripods here.
Yeah, at least 500 tripods, ball heads of all sorts. Look at all the Gitzo stuff.
Yep.
Look at all the, can you zoom in on the Gitzos?
Let's get people cleared on. And you know we're selling really right stuff now.
They're selling really right stuff.
Yep,
best ball head ever. Look at all this stuff. Now these open ball heads are a really good. I mean, not ball heads. These tripods, the open tripods, are a really good value.
Look at how many there are.
Yeah, there's a ton of them. And look at their prices are pretty good.
Yep.
Now that's the ball head.
Come back, Scott. We're blocking.
Sorry.
Who's gonna do the?
Sorry.
They have to do the limbo under us.
All right. Let's go over here.
All right.
So here's how this works. Starting from where we are and going all the way down, there are 39, 40 counters. And each counter, there's like Sigma lenses, Zeiss lenses, Lexar, Nikon, all the way down. And you can try, like you said, anything. So if we can just kind of take a tour, just start on one end, start over here, and just go all the way down. Because you got to see this. This is the thing that people come to B&H for, because there's no place like it on Earth.
This is the world's largest counter. I've always wanted to kind of just lay a slip and slide down here.
All right, you see all the Sigma lenses, Tokina.
Lens Baby.
Lexar, Tamron,
Everything's here, and everything's here for people to try out. That's the whole motto of B&H, is you can come and you can try out any bag, any camera, any lens, and see if it's right for you.
And if you buy it, it goes on a conveyor.
And then it takes the ride
on the
conveyor.
Look at all those bodies.
Good.
Ooh, white glass. Here's the Sony.
Mm-hmm.
There's the Samyang. What is the lens that Samyang makes that everybody likes? Is it their 85 or what is it?
Well,
there's a particular Samyang that everybody
uses. The 14-14 was a great sort of landscape lens, and they actually just came, it was a 14-28, and I think they just announced even a faster 14 that just came out, a 14-18, I believe it is. Sigma did too as well, and that's going to be probably very popular because all the Samyang and Wilkinon lenses and Bauer lenses, they're all manual focus.
All right, can we go back to camera bags? Because they got the camera bags.
Sure.
Selection.
Well, there's the drone cage. You want to see the drone cage?
Let's go see the drone cage.
See the drone cage.
Drone cage!
And the VR area.
Uh-oh. I got to tell you, that's a nice camera work there. We're stuck in the cables. There's no way this was going to go wrong.
Exactly.
Come on here.
But here's our drone
here's
case with the Inspires
case.
In there, the DJI Inspire.
They got an Inspire in there.
Yeah. The Typhoon. We got the Phantom 4. I'm sure the Mavic's in there somewhere too, but it's so small you can't even tell.
I don't see a Mavic.
Yeah, you're right. Maybe it's in someone's pocket. That's the Mavic controller.
Yeah, there is the Mavic controller, but there's no Mavic in there.
Have you played with the Mavic?
I have. I've done a class on the Mavic.
It's awesome. I love it.
Yeah.
It's a drone for everyone.
Is that the GoPro over there?
That does look like the GoPro one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A lot of dronage.
Yep.
A lot of dronage. Major dronage. All right. So I do want you to see the camera bag area. There's a lot of now behind us is all the VR stuff, the virtual reality.
So people can put on the
bunch of GoPro stuff, drone carrying cases. Let's carry our drone around. Okay, we're gonna lose our live stream over on Facebook if we don't wrap this up shortly. So let's at least go to the camera bag. Come on.
Is there a camera bag you're interested in looking at?
Not really. I like all camera bags. I have so many camera bags. You know what I am interested in? I'm interested in a very small bag that will hold all these stupid microphones. All the microphones and cables and connectors that I carry with me on a daily basis for reasons that I can't. All right, so we'll start over here as Low Pro.
Yep.
All right, what bag do you like?
Well, I tell you something. Here's a little brief history. My first job at B&H, I was working on the floor selling bags and tripods. So I've had my favorite bags, but every time a customer came in, they'd be like, okay, I need this bag. And they would tell me the reason, be like, okay, right, I need that bag. So I came home, like within 3 months of working at B&H, I had 10 bags at home. And my wife's like, okay, next bag you bring home, two go out. And I'm like, well, what about all your shoes? And they're like, that's not the same
at
all.
That's not the same. All right, so what bag do you like?
So I like the Peak Design bags.
Ooh, those were nice. Those were really nice. Do you have them here?
We certainly do. Yeah, so let's go take a look. The Tembo bags are also very nice.
Tembos are nice.
Yeah, I like the Tembo ones. It's a close second.
All right.
Hold on.
Frodo. Now we're at Tamrac,
Think Tank, Stylish,
Low Pro, Mindshift makes some nice stuff.
Mindshift is good too.
Yeah.
We might.
Mindshift has like a Moose Peterson bag that's really good.
That's right. Yep, they just work together to create a really cool bag. It might be on one of the front ends. But let's
Low Pro.
Ask. The Peak Design bags, do you have those on display?
Last aisle, all the way to the back.
Okay, so we're going.
Hi, Sarah, how are
you? We're going to go all the way back to this side.
Hey, so look, there's a Sony. So there are these segments here. Gosh, I'm right on the camera here.
Sorry, I was doing my own Zoom.
So they have these kiosks here that actually have Sony employees in them,
mm-hmm.
Panasonic employees, Nikon employees. So they're actually trained by these companies. They're working here inside of B&H. So if you want to come in here, you really want to talk to someone who really is like from the company and knows it on a level, it's one of these big kiosks you see here. Like, look at the Sony one.
Yeah,
it's so brightly lit.
It's very well lit.
Whether
very
you like Sony or not, it draws you to their booth.
To the lights.
There's Panasonic and Nikon. You're just like, Canon's down here. It's kind of dark. Let's get some light on them if we could. background's like one guy there. Let's get some, this is just embarrassing. Let's get some light on it. I would shine my iPhone light, but he's using it.
Right. Right.
Where's the cannon? So Think Tank must be, she said the last.
There's Think Tank.
There, and the peak right here. Boom.
There they are. All right, good, because your favorite bag and mine are in the same row.
Oh,
all right,
perfect.
Let's talk about it.
Perfect, sure. All right, so here's the Peak design.
Yep.
I have this one right here.
Yep, and that was super popular, the most crowdfunded bag ever on Kickstarter.
Yep, absolutely.
Until they came out with these cool backpacks. But I'll tell you, this is actually my current favorite bag. This is...
What?
This is... you know what? I want a smaller bag now that I can just go shooting with.
And
this
doesn't is the... Look, it doesn't scream camera bag.
And it doesn't scream... And this is the Everyday Sling. And when you open it up, this actually held my 13-inch Air right in here. So it'll hold the 13-inch MacBook right in here. And you have one camera, either one camera with a lens, another lens, and a flash. So it keeps it simple. You got some nice storage over here with batteries. Good batteries, bad
nice,
batteries.
Nice. Good batteries,
as well
bad
as
batteries.
An expandable pocket right here. And I love it because you can also attach a tripod.
Is
right
it a sling
there.
Like it goes over your back and
yep.
You sling it around
That's
to
correct.
Open it?
Let's see. I'll kind of...
Here's demo. A live demo.
Demo it here.
Okay. So.
And I can just kind of bring it out and it's, I have, and I can reach in and grab it just like that. Quite easy. Everyday sling. Love it.
Okay. That's $149.
Now, let's look at my favorite one. Captain's Bread Across the Hallway,
which is from Think Tank.
Okay.
It is this little bad boy. It is also a sling. It is, note the price, $84.75. Say maybe not quite half, but still good. It is a sling bag as well. It goes over your head and slings around. Same thing that he did. Now, it doesn't hold quite as much as that one. It doesn't hold your laptop. But if you don't need to walk with your laptop through a city...
Well, who would want to do that?
Who would want to do that? Not us. Look at that. You still got three nice pockets. You got extra pockets here. You don't really have the fancy thing for batteries. But you do have a zippered compartment up front. And I'm wrong, it does have good battery, bad battery. So it has those, and it is very, very lightweight. Very, I mean, it's ridiculously, insanely lightweight. Let's compare
and it. And it makes a bigger size, it looks like, too.
Yes, yeah. But you know what? If you're going to get something that big, get
then you might as well get bigger, right?
That's what I love about this. So a buddy of mine turned me on to this. Okay, hey,
okay.
We've been told it's time to wrap up, because this is the signal we got.
What is that? I can't read lips. What is
You can't. All right. A couple of things before we go. This is important. We have a giveaway today. What are we giving away, Gabe?
I don't know.
No, I'm just kidding. I'm not putting you on the spot. No, you know what we are going to do, though? Can I tell you something? In honor of this show being from B&H Photo, we are going to give away a Think Tank bag. Is it the one I just showed you?
No.
Is it one you want?
Of course.
Ooh. So we're only going to give away that. We're not giving away books or anything or nothing like that. And by the way, I'm just going to tell my cameraman, you have an awesome shot of the ceiling. Tip it down a little bit. There we go. Thank you. I know you can't monitor it very well with the drinking and all. Anyway, so we're going to give away a Think Tank bag. So go to KelbyOne.com/contest and just say, I want to win the bag. And we will put you in there and we're going to send somebody. Doesn't matter where you are in the world either. Just put your name in there. Dude, we ship to everybody. You know why? We're loose with money. Anyway, we'll ship to you wherever you are in the world. Enter, we'll pick a winner, and next week someone will get an awesome Think Tank bag. It will probably be the Urban Disguise, but it might not be. It might be another one. But it might be either the Urban Disguise or something almost as good or something better.
Who knows?
All right. So I want to thank our friends here at B&H for allowing us to crash their store, for hosting us in that beautiful, beautiful room, the suite. Our
it was a suite. It really was a suite.
It was sweet. It was
sweet.
It was
sweet.
It was a sweet, sweet. We want to thank them for being such gracious hosts today. Gabe, thank you so much for being on the show. You are the man. Where can they go see your photography?
So I would direct them to nationalparksatnight.com.
Nationalparksatnight.com. Now, where can they see your class, Gabe?
Well, KelbyOne.
Well, of course, that is so awesome. Yes, you should definitely, now that you know Gabe and you guys have kind of, you know, hung out and stuff and walked through the city and, you know, you're kind of friends now, you should definitely go watch his course over at KelbyOne.com. As you saw, people love it. And you guys went to three different locations and you shared a lot of really good stuff. So thanks, everybody. We will be back in the studio next week, right? I'm not any place, am I? Am I someplace? No.
Livonia.
It's not next week.
No, I'm just kidding.
It's the week after.
Trending Livonia.
Dude, hashtag Livonia. All right, we got to say bye. Take care, everybody, and thanks very much for watching The Grid Live with us.